The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
The apostles gathered together with Jesus and reported all he had done and taught. He said to them, "Come away by yourselves to a deserted place and rest a while." People were coming and going in great numbers, and they had no opportunity even to eat. So they went off in the boat by themselves to a deserted place. People saw them leaving, and many came to know about it. They hastened there on foot from all the towns and arrived at the place before them. When Jesus disembarked and saw the vast crowds, his heart was moved with pity for them, for they were like sheep without a shepherd. And he began to teach them many things. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
We have here in the Gospel the result of two aspects of Jesus' call. The first is that he calls his disciples to come, to learn from him, to become one with him in his understanding of God the Father. The second aspect is that he sends them forth. Sends those whom he has called to follow him, he sends forth to make him known, to do what he did, to be for others what he is for them. And that is the same pattern that is reproduced in our lives. We are called to follow Jesus, to learn from him, to become one with him, in his relationship to God the Father. And then, the other side of that coin is we are sent forth to make him known, to be signs and instruments of God's love to all of those whom we meet. And then, that having been done, there is one other aspect that we see in this gospel. Come apart. Come apart and rest a little. You cannot always be actively coming and going. Sometimes we have to step aside. Sometimes we have to be refreshed. We have to be renewed. In some ways, that is what this feast of St. Blaise teaches us. We know absolutely nothing whatsoever about his life except that he was a bishop in what is now central Turkey, and he was martyred, put to death for the faith in the last gasp of the persecutions under Diocletian. Very shortly after his time, the church gained its freedom under Constantine. That's all we know. However, he became very, very popular for a number of reasons in legends that developed over centuries after his death. And one of them, largely because his feast was celebrated right in the middle of the cold season, we might also say the flu season, he became the patron of those who are suffering any kind of ailment, illness of the throat. There is a legend, there's two legends actually. One was when he was being hauled off to prison to await his martyrdom. A woman came and pleaded with him to restore her pig, which of course was all that she had to live on, who had been snatched away by a wolf. And in his prayers, the wolf brought the pig back was restored to her. This poor woman, that was all she had to live on, and that was a great favor for her. So much so that when he was in prison, she brought him two candles that provided him light in the darkness of the dungeon. And from that, the legend came that anybody who lit two candles on his feast day, which was, of course, the day after Candlemas, which you celebrated yesterday, anybody who lit two candles on his feast day would be freed from ailments of the throat, would be not subjected to that block in our health. The other legend, as we're familiar with too, was that he cured a young boy who was choking on a fishbone. I can identify with that because one of my earliest memories was, and I think for a long, long time, I just did not like fish after that. But I remember having a fishbone stuck in my throat that my mother actually had to reach in and pull out. And fortunately, that took place successfully. But this particular legend makes him the patron of those who are afflicted with illnesses of the throat. Now, why the throat? Well, because if we can't talk, and I realize for some people, other people might consider that to be a really great gift if you can't talk, but if you cannot talk, you cannot proclaim the word of God. So an illness of the throat is actually something that stands in the way of our performing the mission that God has for us. It's not just to give us good health so that we can enjoy stuff. God has something deeper in mind for us, that we make use of our gift of health, whatever it may be, to praise his name and to communicate, to share his goodness and his word with one another. Often that's a word of encouragement when we might be tempted to give a word of criticism, maybe turn that around and give a word of encouragement. That's doing the work of the Lord. That's something we do with our voice. So when we receive the blessing of St. Blaise today, let's pray for the gift of health of our throats and freedom from other illnesses so that we may give glory to God by the words and the deeds of our life.